is the Tire Guard Wireless Tire Pressure Monitor Handlebar Mount.
Alright, so I got this Tire Guard thing, and I figured I'd put it on my motorcycle because I'm a lazy shit. I don't feel like getting down there on the ground and checking the tire pressure every week. Damage, you know, you could do a visual inspection, but that's a pain in the ass finding these damn tire valves. So I'm lazy, at least I admit it, you know. So let me tell you, or show you, or both, what comes with the kit.
You got this thing here, which is, I guess, important. It gives you the readouts and stuff. I'll show you that in a minute. There's a little guard thing, rain guard thing. Comes with a battery. That's pretty good. This Allen wrench thingy for these doodads that keep everything in place once you get them on. These are the things you stick on your valve stems. These things here are spacers that go inside that thing to put... You put that on your handlebar. And then you attach this to that by this. If you can see that. I don't know what the hell that thing is yet, but I'll figure it out in a sec. And the two batteries, so the batteries go with that thing. And it's got a little book, tells you, you know, what to do, so
I'm going to start here. The book is pretty easy to read, and it's all pretty straightforward. So I'll go through this, you know, you get to see it in live time, whatever they call it, as I do it. Not edited. Oh, they put a little plastic thing on the battery. Yay. Alright, now let's make sure I put this in the correct way. Yeah, good. Mitsubishi batteries. Alright. Close that. There you go. So it says, I don't know, a bunch of stuff. I'll program it later. But battery's in anyway. And then I'm going to put the batteries into this thing. So apparently you got to unscrew this doodad. You see? That's number one thing. It looks like these batteries are the same size, so I don't have to worry about any differences in sizes and getting it wrong. Because you know, if I can get it wrong, I will. Shut up out there! Plus is on the top. Let's see here. Minus is on the bottom, I guess. That's the way it looks anyway. So I'm going to just slide that. See, minus is on the bottom. That's a plus right there. So it says in the directions, just slide it on in. And then you screw it again. There you go. Alright. So that would appear to be on there. I don't know how tight you need to get it, but I got it, you know, finger tight. So, number one is done. Let's do number two. Tesla cherries. God. Good thing I don't have arthritis. Alright. Number two, same deal. You unscrew it like that, and then you take the battery and you slide that in. Plus goes on top, minus goes on the bottom. There you go. You slide that in. Oopsie. I noticed as I'm doing it here, that little indicator thingy started blinking at me and doing all kinds of stuff. And I think I know why. They're already communicating. And this tire pressure thingamajig currently thinks that number two is low pressure. Let me show it to you. See? Low pressure on both of them. So, I guess if I hook them up to the tire, it'll tell me what the pressure is. And it just made this red flashy thing at me. I don't know what that means. I'll look that up later. Now let me loosen these things up. This is the next phase. loosen these bad boys. Apparently they kind of fit like underneath, kind of like that, you know. And then once you stick it on the tire valve, you clamp that down, and then this won't move because see that's got a little grooves in it, and that's got little bumps in it, and so they match up, and then you can't move it. So it also, I guess, keeps people from stealing it. Although I imagine if you're an industrious thief, you could probably do it, especially if you had your own Allen wrenches with you. But we won't talk about that. I think primarily that they're on there so that these things don't go flying off when your motorcycle's going down the road at 90 miles an hour. Not that I ever go that speed. I always follow the speed limit. All right, so I got those thingies. I got these thingies. I got this thing. Let's just throw it all in the box, shall we? Comes with a handy dandy box. Ta-da! Yay! And apparently if you can't put it on the handlebars, I don't think I can, I don't think I have the room. It's got this screw thing, and I guess you can stick it somewhere else. I'll tell you where to stick it. So it says here, if the handlebar thing isn't feasible, you're going to have to do it on the brake slash clutch face clamp utilizing this screw if the original equipment is not long enough to secure. And page 10 in the user guide. That's pretty helpful. Me likey. All right, let's go outside.
Oh, sexy.
Hi there. It's me, my Kaylee 7. Getting ready to put these thingies in. So I'm assuming that number one means front. I'm gonna first, I gotta put this thingy on there. Make sure I put this on right. So the stopper thingy goes on first. And then I take this thing and I carefully screw it on. Then it already tells me that my front tire is at 44 psi. I don't think that this thing is properly seated. That's properly in there now. So once you get the grooves, you know, the bumps and the grooves and all that synced up nice, then you can move that thing right on there. I just pull this little ring thing up into this groove thing. And once you do that, you can tighten it down. I assume that's how it works. I don't want to tighten it too much because I don't want to damage the threads on the valve. All right, I think that's... What did Grandma say? Tight is tight! And I'm trying to unscrew it and I can't. So, there you go. First one's done. See how hard that was? That wasn't hard at all, and I'm an idiot.
All right. So, repeat the process. All right, I think it's on there. I think it's on there. I think we're good. Yeah, see I got the 45 and the 44? So far, so good. It's my original thing. I don't know what that is, P98s. I don't know what that means, but it's probably our good sensor in there, right? Stupid. So, now it's time to put on the this thing. So that'll be my next part. Ugh. Whew. Now, time to place this bad boy on my handlebars. The question is, will it go? The problem. Not a whole lot of real estate. You see what I'm saying? So,
This thing here goes on there. Question is, how do the two meet in the middle? How do the two meet in the middle? I don't know. I'm figuring it out. Yeah. Balls! Balls! Balls make it all work! Balls! Oh, you need a screwdriver. See? So, I could put that there and then and have the thing like that, you know? Stick that on there. Squirrels. Now watch out for the squirrels. I'm getting... Hey! They're not coming for me. Certainly not coming for you. I should probably turn on the radio. But then I'll get in trouble with YouTube for copyright infringement because I can't listen to music and video at the same time. This is already pre-approved by the Fuhrer, whoever it is. WMD, is that what they call him? Who is it? Bastards? WMJ, something like that. Alright. No, that won't go there. No, that won't go there either. I got too much real estate, and I don't want to mess with those cables or nothing. So I ain't using this thing. Oh, shoot. This is going to take more than I thought. So I'm looking around for a tool.
I got to get a screwdriver for that thing. A wrench, screwdriver, whatever you want to call it.
So, couldn't find the tools that I bought like 5 years ago that I seldom use. And then I realized this bike came with tools in the back there. So, Harley Davidson, I love you. Oh, that's definitely too big. So, I got no choice. The only one I got is this one right here. And it's one of these star-shaped ones. I call them dark stars. Oh, that was pretty easy. That didn't take much effort at all. Makes me wonder if that was screwed in tight enough. Let's see if a English teaching goofball like me can do this. You'd have to be completely brain dead not to be able to do it. So far so good. If there's any way I can screw this up, I'm sure I will. Oh, jeez. If I can drop anything, I will drop it.